So before we do more problems, let's do a quick lesson on inclined planes, because they're really a fascinating tool for making nature work for us. Now, we already know that Galileo had a lot of fun rolling balls down inclined planes. And if you remember, the reason he did this was because it slowed down motion, allowed him to make some measurements and observations that he couldn't have made with just objects in free fall. The question, though, is why did rolling balls down an inclined plane slow down their motion? Sure, it seems sort of obvious, but let's analyze it. Instead of rolling balls, let's imagine sliding blocks, because the physics of rolling is slightly more complicated than I want to get into right now. So we're zoomed in now, and here's our block, and it has mass m. And we're going to let it slide down this inclined plane. For now, we're pretending this plane has no friction. Remember, friction is the force associated with things rubbing. Well, let's do what we always do and draw a force diagram. As always, weight points straight downwards, and the normal force, and remember, normal means perpendicular, actually points in this direction. And that's because it has to be perpendicular. We're not allowing for any friction. Friction would point up or down the inclined plane. We're only allowing for this normal force. Well, up to now, what we would have done was take this force and break it into vertical and horizontal components. It turns out that's not the best way to solve this problem, because we know from experience that this block is going to slide down the ramp. It's not going to slide straight to the right, or straight up, or straight down. It's going to slide in this direction. So that's the direction we should care about. And how do we care about a direction? Well, instead of breaking this force down, we break the weight down. We replace this downwards force with a force perpendicular to the surface, which I've indicated with this little perpendicular symbol here, and a force parallel, which I've indicated with these two parallel lines. Now, the thing that's really cool is that if this plane was inclined at an angle alpha, we can do some geometry to show that this angle here inside this triangle is also equal to alpha. And since this here is a right angle, we can do trigonometry. In fact, if we want to look at the sine of this angle, for example, well, that's going to equal opposite over adjacent, so f parallel, over mg. And when we solve that, we find that f parallel is just mg times the sine of this angle. And we can do similar thinking to show that f perpendicular is mg times the cosine of the angle. Now let's think about what's going on here. Well, I know that a block on a plane like this is going to slide this way. It won't jump off the plane and it won't accelerate down into the plane. Okay, so that means that this direction, the forces are all set. They're balanced. Fn must equal f perpendicular. In fact, the only unbalanced force here is this parallel force. And this parallel force, since it's unbalanced, is what's causing the acceleration. It must be equal to ma. Well, we can plug in what we know. F parallel is mg sine theta. So this must be true. And this tells me that the acceleration of an object sliding down an inclined plane is equal to g times the sine of theta. Now that's very amazing. This number, sine of theta, is always between 0 and 1. It's always going to make g smaller. So this is exactly why Galileo chose inclined planes. They slow down acceleration. They make it smaller than g. Now, this was a lot of material. If you have any questions, go to the forums and ask. Now we're going to move on to a couple more problem set problems.